more love, more love, more love. The ultimate cure in relational life is more love. Battling with lovelessness, more love. Hated and disrespected, more love. Appreciated and beloved, more love. Simple love is the simple answer. Welcome to Day 9 of our relational series, The Prince. Today, we are speaking on royal integrity. Please permit me this analogy. A man walks into a room, met his wife stab a man to death. She then stood in the transgression and resulting condemnation. To share in the offense together with his wife, the man picks the same knife and struck the dead one with it, staining his own flesh with the blood and the offense. Together, they stand guilty by law as both did kill the man. Looks horrific? No, not as horrific as the scene and the stab in Eden's garden. It was worse. Humanity was stabbed to death, and God got stabbed at the heart into death too in Eden's garden. It was a double stab. A stab to man, humanity, and a stab to God. It's by the stab of sin, man died, and God passed through death. The incident man, Adam, died about 930 years later, and all men have been dying since. God too passed through death about 6,000 years later after receiving the stab of sin in Eden's garden. This is the picture. The prince met the woman with the knife stabbed to the heart of humanity and to the heart of God, and then he willingly and consciously joined his hand to the stabbing knife. It was the woman who saw. It was the woman who desired. Genesis chapter 3 verse 6. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, it was the woman who saw and who desired. What she saw, the man Adam never saw. The desire she had to eat the fruit was not in the man Adam. The woman saw pleasures, the pleasures of sin. The man saw something else, the coming judgment. Scripture says in 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 14, Adam knew the consequences and was not deceived. Like the Lord Jesus saw the coming judgment at Gethsemane garden, another garden, and nearly prayed it off, yet went ahead to join his bride in judgment. The Lord Jesus knew the consequences, but still joined the sin of humanity. Two garden, two incidents, two deaths. The woman desired what was before her. The man had no desire for what was before them, condemnation. Like the Lord Jesus desired not the condemnation of the Father. The woman saw, the woman desired. She saw deception to sin. Desire were prompted in her to lead her captive to eat the forbidden fruit. The man was in full consciousness, seeing nothing but the need to partake in the coming judgment with his bride. No surge of desire rose in him but to join his bride. Adam knew God would judge them, for God had even judged him in advance already in Genesis chapter 2 verse 17, before the woman even came, that eating the evil fruit was death to him any day, any time. The man knew the consequences before he willfully joined his bride. The woman was manipulated into the sin. The man walked in full consciousness into the sin. What just happened here? The man simply took responsibility for his bride. This is royal integrity. This is the royal integrity from the force of love. Love behind it all. The man is the first one to truly demonstrate love in scripture. Royal integrity is from the force of love. How do we get that? The Lord Jesus Christ came to earth and followed the example of Adam to join his bride in eating sin to become sinful. The Lord Jesus joined himself to our sin like Adam did join himself to his sin and desiring bride in Eden's garden. Not because the Lord Jesus saw anything or desired anything sinful. The woman saw, the woman desired. Adam saw nothing, Adam desired nothing. The Lord Jesus saw nothing, he desired nothing. Unlike us, his own sin and desiring bride, the Lord Jesus saw nothing appealing in sin, nor had surge of desire for sinful passion. But for judgment he came into this world. John chapter 9 verse 39 says, "And Jesus said, for judgment I came into this world," end of quote. Meaning, for judgment the Lord Jesus joined himself to our sin. The judgment that will condemn the sin, the tempter, Satan, and equally the judgment that will liberate humanity's sinful stain and release humanity to her eternal destination of life forevermore. The realm of thought is endless. You just can navigate endlessly. Let's use a little turn. Now imagine if Adam had not eaten the evil fruit handed to him by the woman. Please note, Adam did not pluck the evil fruit. The woman gave him hand to hand to eat it. That was prophetic. He didn't pluck a fruit because he never desired it. The transgression was handed to him by the woman. Transferred sin. Even so, the Lord Jesus never plucked the fruit of sin directly. Meaning, Jesus never sinned directly, but sin was handed to him by his bride. Even us, in person. It was a transferred sin, hand to hand transferred. We were the one who sinned, then passed it to the Lord Jesus. The woman's sin passed it hand to hand to man. We sinned, then passed it hand to hand to Jesus. Love accepted the evil offering, a death stab to the heart. But love, in love, redeemed us. Such is the power of God, the power of endless life. Now back to our little roaming thought. What if Adam had not eaten the evil fruit handed to him by the woman? Today, a dangerous saying goes, all men to himself, God for us all. If he had not eaten, he would have by his righteousness judged and condemned the woman. Like Noah, who by his righteousness condemned the world. Like the Lord Jesus Christ, who by his righteousness condemned and eternally judged sin, Satan, and the world, including us in the eternal death of the old man of our existence, but granted us new life in the same process. Obedience always judges disobedience. If Adam had obeyed and not eaten that fruit, he would have judged the disobedience of the woman. So what if Adam had not eaten? God would probably have made him another bride, a better bride. I hear some people say, will God? I don't think so. Well, let's pause the thought here. It's a dead-end thought. No need of generating argument and storm. That's not an option. Love has an unbroken cord. A faithful call. The two are not two but one. One has eaten for the two, so both has eaten. This is how royalty thinks. In marital parlance, two is simply one, whichever way. It is corporate responsibility for both liability and asset. It is called royal integrity. Let's also look at this from a higher place. Man has sinned. God has sinned. This is the line of thought of royalty. God sat down in heaven. When he saw man sin, then there was an assumed notion that he, God, has sinned. The highest royal integrity in motion, God taking corporate responsibility with man. Man sin, God sin. In the person of the Lord Jesus, transferred sin, of course. Sometimes in life, there is just this one thing you never forget, like the love on the cross. The willful conscious love demonstrated on the cross. Please, here is also another deep one, never to be forgotten. The love in the Garden of Eden. Man following the woman into darkness out of willful conscious love. Even though it was a guided or a misguided love. Well, I don't know, but let's put it that way. Love was behind it all. That action was such a masterpiece. That the Lord Jesus copied the full step, action for action, when he too became man. We submit to Christ our Lord eternally for the cross. Now we know better why the woman is yoked to submit to the love of her husband, the love in Eden's garden. Princess, treasure your prince, he first loved you. A love that led to death and the present challenging world. See the royal integrity of your prince dating back to the beginning. And joyfully adore his heart and courage to lead through thick and thin. Lift your prince and he becomes your own lift to the next level, princess. Thank you. God bless you. Grace and David Abubakar with love.